Dean of the school in Pasadena, California, Dr. Lynn Kinley.
Good evening, class.
Good evening.
This is Gregory, and I'm standing for you. Testified. We all have come to understand. And right off the bat, let me say that I, first of all, thank you for your love. Last night was great, too. And the next thing I want to say is that I appreciate things that Dr. Hill has been talking about.
That's right.
And I do agree.
That's right.
I agree with its content. I understand why certain things are said. I'm not talking about what he said, I'm talking about what's in the Bible. Now, I made the statement, everybody has to hold the peace. Right? And that's what was confronted tonight. Now, and let me say that this is not a dispute between Dr. Gill and me. This is not an argument, not fussing and fighting, which I appreciate. Now, I am saying to you what he said to you, self same thing. As he said, if you listen, you're not as far apart as you think. Now, if we go back to the beginning, and we were always taught, now there's some that's been Dr. Carr and his brother, been in classes now before, some of you just cutting out that was I didn't know until the other day, yesterday, that Dr. Kimmy had baptized her in water when he was an older minister. And since then, he's apologized to her several times for doing it. Now, that shows the spirit of a righteous man, right? Now, we have to learn to rightly divide. Now, right off the bat, I can say this, but I want to attempt to explain it. I wish this had come up sooner, because tomorrow, I'm planning to leave and go back to Detroit. So I don't want to look like I said my little piece and cut out. So we all know this was pre-arranged that I had made those arrangements. Now, when we go back to the beginning and come down from there, then we see a purpose drawn out. We see a pro and a con. Now, when I said every man had the Holy Spirit, I didn't say everybody was saved. Because the book says, there's none lost but the son of perdition.
Right.
That's all that's lost. You follow? When you speak to a man concerning Yahweh and the truth, the spirit of that he, in John 8:44, is where he quoted, that you are of your father the devil, he's a liar, a murderer, and from his house. Right? Now the devil didn't grow up to be a devil. You come to that all? Now, Joshua, in the wilderness, when he was tempted, so-called tempted. Wait, let me show you what I'm talking about. See, if we've heard this too, this is not a Bible reading, scripture quoting context, right? Now, everybody can read, but as Messiah said, how do you read? Do you understand? Now, I hope I'm with you. I'm not at a disadvantage in that Dr. Gill is the dean.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, some schools, now, say you did now. Some schools don't make no them watches. He told me about this. Well, by Detroit, I won't say. Don't make no them what somebody else says. If that dean there say it ain't so, it could be true, but then don't nobody believe. Now, I hope we're not like that.
Right.
We want, if If a thing is sold, then let us come and reason together.
That's right.
Now, see, when you said the natural man receiveth not the things of Yahweh, what are you? You're a natural man. Right? You're a physical man, but you understand the purpose of Yahweh. That has been given. So now what are you saying? Do you follow?
Yes.
Don't go to sleep on me now.
No.
See, so when you say a natural man perceives not the things of Yahweh, well, Dr. Kinley, that was a natural man. You see, so evidently it is not the way we're reading. As Messiah said, how do you read?
Well, that's right.
Am I right or wrong?
Right.
So we see that certain things were said to impart divine understanding. Now, he quoted Dr. Kinley, so and that's what we've all done. That even the angels desire to look in. And we had a tendency to think the angels were stupid. They didn't know no more than we did. Just from reading that, that even the angels don't know no more than America. No, the angels knew Elohim. Dr. Kinley said, the angels knew Elohim. But what this is perfect. That's what they did understand. You follow? And I'm saying to you, let me put it this way, I'm going to go back to the root. And you follow. Then you'll see what I'm talking about. And then I'll just shoot straight up. It takes the Holy Spirit in you to condemn you.
That's right.
That's what I'm talking about. I didn't say you're going to fight. I'm saying that Spirit is in all, through all, and back all. That's all I'm saying. And there is no other power other than that of Yahweh.
Right.
That's what I'm talking about. You see?
Right.
When you walk along and you do something wrong, what is that that condemns you? That's the Spirit of truth. Know you wrong. That's the thing that condemns you. That then is, Dr. Kinley would say many, that's God in a body.
Right.
But, and that's his voice in you, but you won't pay it no attention.
Right.
You won't heed it. And you never did suspect that that was him and you talking all along.
Right.
See? Now, this is what I'm saying to you. We're supposed to come to an understanding of Yahweh and his purpose. Not what the man that has not yet come to it. You follow?
Right.
You understand?
Yes, sir.
You see, because you and I were once at that state. We didn't know.
Right.
You follow?
Yeah.
Now, we shouldn't look at it with the eyes. I would say this. I don't go to bars. Nightclub. You see, I don't do a lot of things for my fellow man's sake. It isn't that I believe it's his sin. But I don't want to be a stumbling stone to him. You see? Greater love has no man but to lay down his life. But I already know ain't nothing to drink it. And God said this. Joshua did not die, or neither did Adam, die for your habit.
Right.
You follow? So then why do we do what we do? You follow? Why do we abstain, you see, from a lot of things that cause our fellow man to stumble? In that we have something now, as Dr. Gill said, to comfort. You see? And as you learn of Yahweh, you understand? It replaces. You understand? Like I used to have a ball playing with a big band. You know what I mean? Drums. And that was me. You know what I mean? Even one time, my first wife had said, what do you think the most of, your drums or me? She shouldn't have asked me that. My drums. Now, here's what I mean. I didn't know what you'll do. My wife. You know what I mean? You may go to do something, change your mind. But my drums, I felt I could just pick them. So I was in love with them. You know what I mean? All right, I made it. So then her feelings from that day forward were with her. But see, she didn't ask me to make a choice between them. So now look, let me try to go at it this way. Now keep it in mind that I agree with the content of what he quoted.
Right.
What I'm saying is that we collectively speaking don't understand. In other words, When you chastise a child, let me put it this way. I got four daughters. Says, Daddy, I've been good, haven't I? I cleaned up my room, and I've been what you want me to be, haven't I? You think I've been pretty good? Good girl? Can I have an ice cream cone? See, now all this other was guided up to this. You follow me? Now I may say, here, go get your knife. See, but I wasn't, you see? You see what I mean? And she hasn't yet learned all you have to do is just ask. You know what I mean? But she got to think this picture, so when she lowered the boom on me about the ice cream cone, you see, I ain't got the heart for you now. You know what I'm saying? Now this is what I'm saying. That it isn't that we're deceived.
Right.
You know? In other words, I gave her the money, I would say, for the ice cream cone, but I wasn't deceiving the trick she pulled.
Right.
You follow? Now this is what I'm talking about. I'm talking about an infinite God.
Right. Right.
And there is no power other than Him.
Right. Right.
And that's what I'm talking about. I'm saying that the devil, though he's a devil, he is not an independent being.
Right. Right.
That's what I'm talking about. And it takes Yahweh's spirit in him to cause him to be either way.
That's right.
Right? He's going right. It's Yahweh's show.
That's right.
Now, I didn't say he was saved now. I didn't say that.
Right.
I said he's got the Holy Spirit. And I'm saying if you don't abide in truth or learn of Yahweh, he's going to, that same truth in him, that same Holy Spirit in him, is the same going to have him.
That's right.
You follow? And I agree with this, that. As Dr. Gill said about, did you clean up your room? Yes, that's true. See, the difference to me, I'm speaking for me now, truth to me is truth. You follow me? I don't see. In other words, there is nothing else but divine truth.
Mm-hmm.
That's all it is. There's no line of demarcation to me. See, just like we say, everybody has the Spirit, but everybody don't have the Holy Spirit. I don't see no difference. I'm telling you, I don't. Not from what I was told. I'm saying that this Spirit dwells in everything. And that's what I'm talking about. Now, I'm not looking at it with the eyes of the man that don't see. I'm looking at it with the eyes now of y'all. And now I see Yahweh in every cosmographical structure in the universe. That's what I'm talking about.
That's right.
That's right.
You see? You can't serve two masters.
That's right.
It's like somebody says, oh, I believe the world's going to go on for 50 more million years. So what? You ain't going to be around. You know, I mean, why argue that contention? I mean, why contend about it? You see? Now, you read in the Bible. To try to move along, but we pulled the clock so we could take it. Because I wanted to take it back to Pasadena with me, so they could see you. Now, they say Messiah went into the wilderness of Sinai. Straightway after he was baptized, and he went into the wilderness of Sinai. I mean, well, you know what I'm talking about. In the wilderness, and he was tempted. You see? Now you read it, and he was tempted. See, now somebody said Messiah wasn't tempted. You got to think of it. He was tempted. Right?
Right, that's right.
But now, all you gotta do is keep reading. It is written that thou shalt not tempt. Now we didn't say that there wouldn't dry.
Right.
You see, no, I didn't say it wasn't that clear, it was dry tempting. You see? In other words, him tempting him was foreordained. That's a part of the purpose. Yahweh is playing out these parts.
Right.
You see? To cause those whom he is revealing himself to see both sides of the story. You follow me? That's what we got this play down to. Listen, to me there has been but one man.
Right.
That's the man Yahweh.
That's right.
When I say Yahweh, I'm talking about Yahshua. I'm trying to clarify. I'm talking about Elohim. I'm talking about God. Ain't never one man. This whole purpose is his story.
Mm-hmm.
And he's playing all the roles.
Right.
We being many constitute one vow.
Right.
Now that's something the devil can't catch on. How can it be? You follow? And Yahweh even showed you, you had many members. I got cells, heart, lungs, ribs. You see what I mean? Fingers, toenails, fingernails, hair. Well, it did have some, but anyway. You follow? But just one thought. Now the devil can't forget anything. Now that man that don't discern, that man, as you call that man that don't discern that, is a satanic spirit incarnated in a body, and you will never.
That's right.
See? So I agree with what you're saying. You follow? That does not say that his spirit, which is true.
Mm-hmm.
You see, you can't make Yahweh's spirit true and untrue.
Mm-hmm.
You can't make Yahweh's spirit holy and unholy.
Right.
You see? Yahweh's spirit. We say things in the school for a purpose, to impart things. When we say Holy Spirit, we're trying to give you, impart the idea that it's not contaminated.
Right.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It ain't necessary to say holy.
Right.
You understand? When did they ever get unholy?
Right.
And even the devil is holy. Somebody said, oh my God, take him down now. What I'm saying is, Yahweh's creed.
Perfect.
He is a perfect deceiver. Yeah. Now, can you say that? Why did Yahweh make the devil? He ain't no good. He said, yes, he is. Good for the purpose Yahweh created. Now, that's what I'm talking about. And I see Yahweh working in the devil. How would you feel if we in these schools teach that Satan is a liar and all of a sudden he starts telling the truth? Then he made you out of life. You know what I'm talking about? So you can bank on him. You see? But now who set him up?
Yahweh.
And what did he set him up for?
You
see? For you. Now I just see. That which is under salvation and that which is under damnation. You know? That's what I'm talking about. You see? I'm not saying that he's holy, he knows the truth. No! Look, I know that he's Judas. You understand? Was crucified the night before and was not present on the day of Pentecost. You see, I said Judas was crucified, hung himself, I should say, not crucified, but hung himself the night before. You understand? Yahshua was crucified. So then that showed you he wasn't present on the day of Pentecost when the secrets were revealed. You see? You follow? Now, let me try to go at it. And you watch the time for it. Let me try to go at it the way I was shown. You see, and like I say, we do a lot of things, you know, like if then nobody was real new man. Well, maybe I can say it and you'll understand. Or I'll explain it. Thank you to somebody. If you come to me with no understanding, and you say, Glenn, when my mother died, did she go to hell or go to heaven? Now, either you answer that question truthfully, you know,
right,
or steer them in another direction.
Right.
You see, because you say, no, your mama went to hell just like everybody else. Now, you suddenly turn them off. Because they don't want to hear that. They don't want to hear their mama. Now, then that means you want to explain hell. Sure, or the phrase, you're going to have to explain it. You just can't say, no, your mom would tell me like it all. You know? Now, I don't want no more of that fool. That's y'all talking about. You know what I mean? That's what you're talking about. But see, if we hang around long enough, then these things begin to clear up. Now, why? This is what I can't. Well, let me do it. Here's the class. This is Romans 1:19. The cloud is here, but I'm directing your attention to a focal point. There's a spirit. You can add holy if you want. Because it is holy. You're not wrong doing that. It's source, substance, I don't have time. Bow,
you have that?
Say bow, say glimmer. This is all in all, that's all.
That's right.
Now, we say this is a mercy of knowledge. If he remained like that, how could he call his creatures to know? Now, but we're attempting to explain and prove that Yahweh is fixed by the things that are made.
Right.
You follow? Now, within this cloud, Yahweh took on shape form. That form is called Elohim, right?
Right.
Is that right?
Right.
Now, here's a cloud. Here's the dust of the earth. This dust is the self-same thing.
That's right.
As a cloud.
Right.
You see? Now then, which part of the cloud did it take to make up Elohim? You
see?
You can't tell, can you? You see? Neither can you tell what particle of dust it took to make his body. Now what you're doing is probably comparing natural things with spiritual things. You see what I'm talking about? And now what you begin to see, you see, that this is Elohim putting on a body.
That's right.
You
follow?
Right. Now so then really, see that's what the purpose of Yahweh is to take. We'll just go ahead and call this a natural man. Yahweh is going to reveal to the natural man who he is.
Right.
All right.
You see? Joshua said, let me say this. If we look at it according to purpose now, here's Adam died. First of all, he was alive, right?
Right.
Now, in Adam, all died.
Right.
Now, if everybody was dead when Messiah come on the scene, this is what he told him. He said, say I not in your law.
Right. Right.
You're Elohim.
Right.
No provision, no nothing. That's who you are. You see? Now, I know they didn't understand that.
Sure.
So then I agree with what he said. The spirit of truth has not yet, because Yahweh had appointed a day.
Mm-hmm.
But but that did not disannul the fact that this, you understand, was in them.
All
right. That's what I'm talking about.
That's right. Yeah.
You can't put this. You can't take, you don't have the power to say this in or out of them.
Right.
Yeah. You talking about Yahweh being pure spirit. I'm letting it be pure. You see? Without any lines and demarcation whatsoever.
Sure.
You see?
Yeah.
And that's what we're trying to preach the gospel, that every man should come to this. You understand? Though he's got it, he don't recognize it.
That's
right. I didn't say he knew. And you ain't saying, though the man across the street got, I'm saying if the Holy Spirit, if you went over there to explain the person to Yahweh, he can't do it. But I'm saying still, Yahweh in him. Because his body is formed, you see, just like yours. Now if there was something different in his body, you see what I mean? Then you say he ain't got it. You see what I'm saying? That's all I'm talking about. I didn't say that he could preach, he could teach. I'll tell you something else. If anybody in the world at the time of the Bible here that knew the truth, it was Judas. That's right. He's the only one who knew who he was. You saw? Well acquainted when he was one of the cats out here. But his pride, what it is, he'll never tell you. You see, his purpose is to see to it that you get lost.
Right.
That you be lost with him.
Right.
And that's what until the Holy Spirit, from a knowledge comes, that's what keeps you warm. You see what I mean? It's called that I can find another member warning my body. Now, even though I said that, I don't believe, the way the Bible put it, that he had two members warning his body.
That's right.
Not after he was called to third head. But he said that to me. One time they said, it is better that you be a giant, not to even touch a woman. Well, the man was a union. You follow? And he's the union. So he went and asked Yahweh to take it away from him.
That's right.
Yahweh said, my grace is sufficient. You see? You follow? In other words, Paul was going along with it to draw men unto Yahweh. He knew before he went to ask y'all he wasn't going. He knew why he was a eunuch according to the person.
That's right.
Do you understand what I'm saying? He understood it. But they didn't understand. They said to him, you have not understood. Doc Kinley, we say, well, let's look at it with him. He had an advantage of us by having a panoramic vision of revelation, didn't he? He said, nevertheless, when you learn, you can do the same thing I can do.
Right.
And we didn't see how we could ever come to that. Mm-hmm. But it was there.
That's right.
What it is. It is in you that has to be resurrected.
Yes. Right.
That's the power that's latent in you.
Right.
You follow? That's what we're trying to warn every man. What he's got. That's of Yahweh and not of himself.
Mm-hmm.
You see what I mean? Right. Because if he laid claim to it within himself, and continue to deny Yahweh, then he shall suffer loss.
Mm-hmm.
See, that's all the gospel is preached for a witness, not to create Yahweh, not to create Elohim, not to create Son. It's preached for a witness.
Right.
You see? Now, as I'm saying, coming down from this, then this death third is the self same thing. That's the cloud. This is taken, this is, well, let's put it this way. This is heaven. This is earth. See? Now, actually, earth abides in heaven.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. All
right.
These are metaphors.
Right.
You understand? I can say some of them. Ain't nobody gonna never die.
Right.
You see? In Yahweh, there is no death. What we call death was sleep.
That's right.
You see? We said it now. Dr. Kinley is not dead. You see, now here's somebody that don't understand. Go out there and say, well, great. Richard and I were talking. Dr. Kinley said, for many years, you'll never throw dirt in my face. No, I mean, you see what I mean? That wasn't faith you talking about. See, now this is what I'm talking to you about. I'm talking to you as sons of Yahweh. I'm speaking to you as Elohim, not as natural men of the world. You see, understand? That's how I'm talking to you.
That's right.
You're supposed to recognize what it is in the man by the fact that this pattern I've been taught is immutable. Now, why? If it's what Dr. Gill, the spirit, soul, body.
Right.
Or the Father, the Word, Holy Spirit. Right?
Right? That's right.
If he's the Father, the Word, you say he ain't got the Holy Spirit, then what is he got? Give me a name here. You see, it's immutable. But I'm saying, what with the gospel, the preaching of the gospel is preaching from heaven. Is that the quick in that sense? You see, would you plant a seed knowing it wasn't no good?
No.
You see? I asked Dr. Kinley just shortly before they went to California. I said, Doc, then out in front of 624. Do we know who's gonna be saved? He said, no, we knew that, but sit down and write a letter and get it over with. So the gospel just preached. You see? Now the man that rejected, we're supposed to know what spirit that is. That's that spirit of anti-Messiah. Put it that way. You see what I mean? But listen, when you understand, even the devil is eternal.
Yeah.
The devil is eternal.
Oh, that's right.
Then that he has to get right on out. Every creation got to get right on out. You understand? That makes his damnation eternal. You follow? Now, if we recognize the agony in with that spirit of Yahweh in us, the agony of conscience, never rejoicing, never, you understand? Then that's the thing causing you to flee from. And that takes the gospel in order for you to see. I'm not denying it. But I'm saying this to you. Why preach to a man if he don't have it?
Right.
You know, it's the same thing. Why plant a seed? And I preach that Dr. Gill, Dr. Kinley, you, or nobody else is going to reveal nothing to nobody.
Right.
You can, this way you ain't going to take home clothes.
Right.
But it should be the unity of the Spirit that's dwelling in you.
Right.
You know, Messiah said, here's how you get into trouble. Messiah come along and said, John said, in the beginning was the Word. Word was with Yahweh. Word was Yahweh. Right? The Word was made flesh.
Right.
Now here he is walking around and says, I have my own self to do nothing. Now that's Yahweh in the body. Then who is this that's doing it? But it's in part the idea that it's not flesh and blood doing it. You follow me? It's to get us away from you trying to glory in his sight with this thing on. So it's the temple of Yahweh, it's got to go.
Right.
See that? That's what, this is what I was taught. And I'm saying that if the pattern is immutable, I mean, I don't play with words holy. Or you know what I mean when you say everybody got the Spirit but not the Holy Spirit? I don't see no difference in it. Now there may be some, I don't see it. Neither was I taught. I'm saying it's Yahweh in every. It's Yahweh through all, in all, and that's all.
Right.
Now somebody says this, come out of open, and I talked to them about it. They said, you mean to tell me the devil is Yahweh too? Or the devil is Yahweh gonna send his own self to the lake? You see, we don't understand.
Right.
Yahweh is the lake.
That's right. That's right.
Exodus 25:40 says, Yahweh our Elohim is Yahweh and what? You understand? Now where can you get out of the presence of that? Well, when he makes his ministry flames of fire, then that fire don't bother them.
That's right.
The same thing that'll destroy him for eternity is the self same thing that you rejoice in.
Right.
You see?
That's right.
And keep it in mind, children, you're looking at a purpose drawn out. That we don't always want to speak with as though Pentecost has not come to us. You know what I mean by that? Yeah, I can see that Noah didn't know it all. I can see it. I can see Adam as Yahweh, Elohim, Joshua, manifest in the Bible. I can also see him as a man. You see, because there is no part. You understand that he is not. You can't make him all Adam and not Yahweh. You can't make him dumb and you be smart.
That's right.
You see?
That's right.
Well, so what Pentecost does, wait a second, what Pentecost does, I think Dr. Gross said it, doesn't that? It revealed what already was.
Right.
You see? Now the man didn't know, you see, as far as collectively speaking. And neither did the angels know. But on the day of Pentecost, the angel and the man were reconciled into one body. Do you know what I mean by that?
Yep.
What the angels didn't know, what the man didn't know, was brought together. He said, this way, I get all those in heaven, those in the earth, you see, you know, those in the one body. And that's been accomplished. You see? Now, when that thing is revealed to me, then I begin to see Yahweh all the way back from me. You see? Do you understand?
Yeah,
I'm telling you, Abraham is him. See? You follow me? In other words, there's nobody, no man has ever been able to bump a crate or Yahweh. You're not doing that. If somebody says, well, Dr. Gill, I'm like, no, you said, I believe him, and I ain't never coming back. Hey, that's a perfect back here.
That's right.
That's been why I don't get excited and call all out about it.
That's right. Well, that man gone that way.
Well, you're supposed to know that if you preach the truth and he rejects you, then you're supposed to know what's there.
That's right.
Now, you're not going to convert the devil.
Right?
This is what I'm talking about. But it's still that truth. Dr. Kinley said in our feast room, said, my prayer to you is that you never have to hear the word. Department of Media Workers in the IDMR. See? But rather hear the word, come ye blessed of my Father, and inherit the kingdom that was prepared for you before all. Sound right? See? And that's when tears came. Because I had heard him say,
you know not how to pray as you ought.
You understand?
But the Spirit maketh intercession for it.
What's he talking about? You know? But I used to always say this. When he called and said, I was glad when they said that was going to the house of the Lord. You know what I mean? That's what I did. That's what I did. No. Then I found out that his blood was the house of God. And it's because he went on back and talked about Job before he took him over to Canaan's land. From me and my household. He was his father's house. You understand? He was in it all. You understand? And I understood. You see, but I'm saying that Yahweh is calling us to know both sides. To cause us of his spirit to be fully resurrected in us. Right. You see, that we know, I know what you think simply by what I thought. In that Yahweh, it wasn't that I was dumb and stupid, but that's Yahweh preparing you.
Right.
Can you understand that? Let me put it another way. It was said to the founder once, God has me, that's when I say God because that's the name we use. When I say those names, I haven't slipped up them. I'm going to try to quote it verbatim. He said, God had me in the Roman Catholic Church. So Dr. Kinley said, did God appear to you and say you joined the Roman Catholic Church? He said, no. He said, well, then don't blame it on me. He said, now, since there's none else but y'all, he assumes the responsibility, but he's not guilty. You follow? In other words, when you say cast your burdens upon him, every damn thing we do, I kick somebody to me. You understand what I'm talking about? Bam! You understand? I say, well, God called me to do that. That's not what we're talking about. That's not how I mean it. That is not the spirit of salvation doing that. But it's still the thing that condemns me. Then you shouldn't have done that. You know you were wrong. That's that voice of God. That is the Holy Spirit in the man. Or Yahweh's Spirit in his own tabernacle.
Mm-hmm.
And that's until you understand. And you understand?
Right.
If, and what that is warned. Then you're going to always do that. Just to, in other words, now look. Dr. Kinley, you say, he taught us for years. The mystery of Yahweh and the mystery of iniquity.
Right.
He told us finally there ain't but one mission.
Mm-hmm.
That's the mission, yeah.
Right.
You get it? All I'm talking about is growing.
Yes.
See, I'm telling you, truthfully, I have no argument with what Dr. Gill said.
Mm-hmm.
I don't. And I don't think he has any argument thus far on what I'm talking.
Mm-hmm.
Hopefully he is. I'm not looking at it with the eyes of when I didn't understand. You follow me? The prophet said this, to give me wisdom, give me knowledge, but above all, give me understanding. Let's understand what you got. Somebody said,
well, since I'm Yahweh, I can take a gun and blow your brain.
Now, you don't understand what you got.
That's right.
That's what I'm talking about. You got to be whipped and nails in there. Very thin. You know? Very thin. And you listen. It takes knowing Yahweh to pervert the truth. Ain't nobody ever, that's the reason why the world, you understand? They ain't been able to convince nobody they don't know the truth. But that's why I warned the other Sunday. We that know, you see, all you have to go to heaven. The saint that knew Elohim was able to pervert.
Yeah.
You understand? A third of the whole. You follow me? So nobody out here like Billy Graham, he ain't no problem.
Yeah.
You understand? Am I right?
Yeah, that's right.
Other teachers. whether they be president, dean, or what, they ain't no problem.
That's right.
When you know.
That's right.
Well, Dr. Kinley used it for many years in our state across the pond. Used to call the Atlantic Ocean the pond. And he directed our attention to the state over in the valley. Ain't one over in the valley. Matter than me.
That's right.
See, what is that? What is Satan? Satan is an erroneous doctrine, or the doctrine of Yahweh perverted.
That's right.
They have to know Yahweh perverted. You understand? Now why? Some say.
Well,
priest.
Well, we are freedom. That your body is a temple of God. Therefore, you're not smoke, you're not drink, because you're fine.
Now what you talking about, what he talking about, ain't saying. Just like him. Huh? But see, we don't talk that way no more. We know now. We didn't know to read then. You see? There's Messiah talk. There's nothing that's without that can devour me. If that is. So don't blame me getting Richard upside the head every time I say, don't you blame that on what I'm smoking and drinking. That's a satanic spirit. Now once righteousness is preached to me, or that spirit of our Father that's in us is resurrected, you understand? Then that stops the hand from harm.
Right.
You understand? But it has to be in you. It's not a vital force upon nobody. It's always been that seed latent in you. It's always been Yahweh. And we didn't recognize who it was. You see? And this is all I'm saying. We should be preaching and teaching from a knowledgeable understanding. Now, if somebody got up here and said, I couldn't disagree with what the apostle said, he read them. You understand? But I understand why he did. They spoke what they did. Nobody knew that Simon. Nobody knew that Joshua was Yahweh. The book said it was his. Right? You follow? But that didn't change the fact that that's who he was. It's just all what he did. Because if our gospel was his, is his there, everybody? Is it there with Paul? No, in conclusion, children, I'm saying, see, if we read and read, we can seemingly take read this and knock that one in the head. You know that? And take you read something and knock me in the head. That ain't what it's about.
Right.
It's understanding the level, I'll put it that way, by which one is speaking.
Right.
You see what? Do you know that Yahweh, I could say, Yahweh did not have to create nothing, remain pure spirit, and save anybody he wants. I could say that, but that don't explain nothing.
Right.
So then why say it?
Right.
You do it as Yahweh did. See, break it down.
Yeah.
See? I don't know no better way to do it than the way he does. You see what I'm saying?
Right.
But this is what I'm saying. I'm trying to tell you, I thought of many things, but I was involved in trying to tell you. You know, most speakers, when they get up here, you'll have me going this way. You're not supposed to stand in one place, no. But I'm saying, that's what I was mainly listening to. But I'm glad that he gave me the opportunity to explain to you what I mean.
Right.
I think that's admirable. You see? And that's what all of us should do.
Right.
See, he doesn't talk behind my back or me behind him.
Right.
Now, perhaps if we could establish that, kind of brotherhood, you see,
right.
With all schools, we would grow.
Right.
But then we begin to understand, we understand, look like, if you came to Pasadena, I'd defy mine to root for me,
mm-hmm.
And be against who's teaching. You better recognize the Holy Spirit wherever.
That's right.
Ain't nobody playing, you know, like
Pasadena, ball team, Springfield.
Some schools do that.
That's right.
You get up. But I'm saying that's some of the things that's going on. And all I'm saying, did you understand what I mean? Yeah. I'm saying that his being permanent, yeah, it is in all things. It's him in the death,
yeah,
that condemns it. Now, that being my father dead, therefore now no more condemnation to them that now recognize through the preaching of the gospel that they're in Yahshua's house. Then I said this, now, the same thing in the book. I said there was no devil in the kingdom. People done this. Go get it. Go get it. Yeah, my goodness. Go get it. Now, this is what I'm saying. This is the kingdom. This is the kingdom. Not saying ain't nothing satanic in it. And that's why I didn't say there wasn't in the world. That spirit that gave us a fit.
Now, can I ask one question? Yes. And again, I'm like this. I'm not. No, go shoot. Shoot. I'm not. 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 I'm not
not that light.
You understand?
That's right.
He was not that light.
That's right.
Okay, now a distinction seemingly has been made. Can you clear that up for me?
Okay. Now this is what I'm talking about. And that's good. That's a problem we have to get out of. Look, some say that John the Baptist lost the Holy Spirit. That can't be any so. Who do you know that never lost the Holy Spirit? No, you got it read. You know, you may read something like this, like John doubted, he passed in the prison. Because what John is asking in the prison, actually pointing him out, he don't understand why he's in jail.
That's right.
Now, when he asks, wait, is you the one? Or a job, you understand? You know, if you ask Dr. Kinley a question, he didn't say you lost the Holy Spirit. So then why should we in turn say John lost the Holy Spirit? Because he asked the question. You follow?
Yeah.
Look, let me put it this way, because you got to get out of here. I'm saying, and I'm trying to show, Yahweh, through his own method, purpose of purpose, and then put parts in them to play. For example, when Peter asked the question, how often should I forgive my brother? You can read that, you can't find where nobody was doing nothing to Peter.
Right.
You see? Right. You can't, but he's got to call him to order. Yeah. You see, that he might answer, not 7 times, but 70 times. All I'm trying to impart, you have to see a purpose. You see, and you can't pick it up down here. In the middle. You have to see it started from here, from the beginning. Then you see this part played out. Then you see them, look, if we can see from Pentecost out, we being many make up one body. You follow? Then we ought to be able to see from this, from Adam down to Messiah, they being many made up the self same body. No separation, no division. You see? Do you understand? Let me put it this way, because I know you've got to go out there. I heard the 5 minutes bell. Yahweh put you through all that he put you through. And Satan would cause you to think, I'm a sinner. I ain't no good. I can't be saved because I ain't no perfect. No, that's Yahweh teaching you. Can you understand that? That's Yahweh teaching you. The pros and the cons. You see, knowing one man, in that you know them all. You follow? This is the greatest. That's why I'm crazy about school. This school is the greatest teaching in the world.
That's right.
We in the school of school.
Yeah.
You see that? Which is the universe in itself knows. And all that's happening to you is Yahweh himself in you. Teaching. Right. See? Now you may turn around and say, Paul said, why does a man condemn himself for the thing he permitted? He smoked a cigarette. And I'm a sinner. Why do you condemn yourself for the thing you permit?
Because you don't understand.
See, so I'm saying, no, they didn't understand collectively. Nobody did. You see, I cannot let them know this, that Yahweh had appointed a day in the which he revealed. You see? Now, all I'm saying is to conclude. We're looking at that state from Pentecost. And we begin to see, let me show you. See, this angel, Elohim, created an innumerable company of angels. See, this goes on, right? Now, this out of Adam comes Eve and a whole generation of mankind. See, what I've done is I've reconciled the two. See, now, here's what I should start doing. This one so loved it, attribute, that he comes down and creates love by the pattern of himself. Adam so loved his wife that he gave up his wife. You see? Now, I shouldn't see that down here with Yahweh. Only, I should see that starting from here.
Right.
Why? Because he declared the end from the beginning. He didn't declare the end from the middle. See, that's what I'm talking about. So I say that's what Pentecost does. Like Dr. Kinley said, about a giant Japanese thing. It just opens up. You understand? Where you see the whole scope of it. So I'm saying, I'm going to repeat. Here's the cloud, here's the dust. You see? Cloud. You understand? That's the self-same thing in principle now. You see? You follow me? Here's an angelic host coming out. You understand?
Yeah.
Now, we said this. This is not where Joshua was crucified.
That's right.
We got it straight now.
Right.
This is where he's crucified.
Right.
You see, well, that's all I'm saying. You got to see everything from here. You get it? Now, when you that to me, what Dr. Gill said, is the whole understanding comes. That's when you really know. You follow? And then you begin to see Yahweh in everything. You see, and you pervade him that way, trying to get your fellow man to come to that. You see? Now you can't come to something that you're not. Can you?
No.
You see? All that's happened to us is we, through the preaching of the gospel, have been made aware of who we are.
That's right.
You see? Now, this may sound hard, but this is not the only way for Yahweh to save folks. Through coming to class. How did he know? You know who taught me this? Found himself. He said, there are many people that would not join no kind of class. Now look, don't you think after you just started class,
You know what Glenn said that. You're right.
I didn't tell you that.
That's right.
So don't say I said. This is where Yahweh gonna save me and you. You won't attend class.
That's right.
That's how he's saving you. You were the high saving somebody else. Yes. But I'm saying Yahweh had many ways to save. And Dr. Kinley said this in conclusion. I heard you say it. He said there are many people that just believed in their heart. They will have created something.
Right.
They wouldn't join this school. Okay, if one of them kind of freaky grow boys, like you said. But just believe me. He said on that deathbed, Elohim appeared to them just the same thing. See that? Paul looked at that and said, Yahweh no time. See that? Well, now this is where he declared you an Anakim. So that's your best way.
Now, what
I'm saying is you be aware. Ricky, I'm sorry I wasn't able to complete. I know it's unfair, you know. You understand? But I'm saying the time is gone. You know? I want to be obedient. I want to be obedient while I'm here and disobedient while I'm here. I want to be obedient to the same way you got it set up. But I hope I've explained this part in what I mean. All I'm saying is that spirit of our Heavenly Father is in all, through all, and at all.
of all